Well, another key question in the minds of many is whether the THAAD battery, when deployed to Seongju, can in fact effectively tackle missiles launched by North Korea. Our Kim Jung-soo turned to experts for their analysis.
South Korea's defense ministry has conducted a military simulation test to verify THAAD's effectiveness against North Korea's Rodong intermediate-range ballistic missiles, the results of which it has declined to specify. Simulation was conducted under the assumption that North Korea will attack the port city of Busan in South Korea by using the same type of ballistic missile that was test-fired on July 19. North Korea launched three missiles from Hwangju, south of Pyongyang, towards the East Sea on Tuesday. Those missiles were identified as two Scud tactical ballistic missiles and one Rodong missile. The Rodong missile is often recognized as one of the most difficult rockets to intercept, with a possible range of 1,300 kilometers at speeds of Mach 7. The simulation also assumed that North Korea will shorten the range of missiles to 600 kilometers by firing them at a higher launch angle. The distance between Hwangju and Busan is roughly 500 kilometers, while Seongju, the chosen location to deploy the THAAD battery, is located 100 kilometers away from Busan. While the ministry has declined to release specific details, it has stressed that THAAD, with an effective range of 200 kilometers, can stop Rodong missiles flying at altitudes between 100 and 150 kilometers, which is impossible to do with the current Patriot missiles that have an operation altitude of 15 to 40 kilometers. Flying at altitudes between 100 and 150 kilometers, which is impossible to do with the current Patriot missiles that have an operation altitude of 15 to 40 kilometers. Numerous experts have agreed on THAAD's effectiveness and have also called for more preemptive measures by the South Korean military.
Nuclear war is a game of seconds or even milliseconds. With THAAD, Seoul can defend itself from Pyongyang's initial offense and save enough time to muster an effective counterattack. The defense ministry also has to remember that the current THAAD system does not cover Seoul effectively, so it should look into further developing its Korea air missile defense system.
I have urged for the THAAD deployment from a very long time ago. As of now, it is painfully clear that South Korea cannot stop North Korea's high-altitude attacks with its current arsenal.
The simulation comes amid a massive protest staged by residents of Seongju on Thursday to express their dissatisfaction with the government's decision. Kim Jung-soo, Arirang News.